was on the Atlantic on the sea. We're out west, and so Davis's family went to sea for a good education. They sent back to Kentucky, to Lexington, to study at Transylvania. And from there, he went to West Point, became a professional soldier, fought in several skirmishes, and then he went into the United States House of Representatives. And then the U.S. Senate, it's the Senate from Mississippi. Well, when Lincoln is elected president, he's taken his oath of office. And the Civil War hadn't broken out yet. That doesn't happen until April. But Lincoln has taken the oath of office, and seven states said, we quit. We're not going to be part of the country anymore. We're going to form our own nation. This is as radical as you can get. It was an awful time in our nation's history. And so Lincoln says in his inauguration address, my goal is to bring us back together again as one nation. And one of those states that quit was Mississippi. So Davis resigns his seat in the U.S. Senate, goes home to Mississippi, and they put him in as president of the Confederacy. So I mean, you want to stretch American history a bit, and I guess you could say we had two presidents at one time, and they were both native sons of Kentucky. But the good thing is, Lincoln prevailed on his promise to bring our country back together again. And over there is a man named Edward McDowell. McDowell, when he even at your age, he wanted to be a doctor. He wanted to be a physician when he grew up. When he was old enough, he studied medicine here in the United States. He went overseas to study at what then was considered the best medical school in the world, in Edinburgh, in Scotland.